Alright guys, and welcome to a testing video. As you can see, we are testing patch 1.3. It is beta at the minute, so there is a possibility if you mix mods in there, your computer is going to explode in a flaming ball of terror. Hopefully not, but possibility is there. It is beta. Right, to install it, obviously you download it from the links through FSUK and various other places. You can't get it from the updates page on the mod thing, but it's not hiding. It's not like it's hidden. Anyway, install it, double click it, bloody yada yada, installs, happy days. If you want to go back to 1.2 for any MP or issues you're having with it, just download the 1.2 patch and install that over it, happy. It's working for me. All else fails, well, before you put 1.3 on there, make a backup of your my documents anyway, just to make sure you've got it saved elsewhere. Like I say, it is a beta, shit could go wrong. And just keep that backup that you've got, uninstall the game, reinstall the game up to patch 1.2, then put your stuff back in and you're back to where you were. Right, without further ado, let's put a few things right here, because people are bitching about this patch, saying whining. No, just enjoy it. They have made improvements, as this video will show. Let's do this. Right guys, we're going to start off with cedars. Now this is the Vedastat is a big cedar. I've seen these things in low life. They are huge. But I don't think there's really much you can see in this particular part. The difference is when you're dragging it around. So I'm trying to do. That's probably not going to work. I'm trying to do another voiceover here. Pay attention to the speed here. I think we're maxed out at 12 mile an hour. So yeah, the case has it in hand. This is patch 1.2. This is what we used to. I was kind of hoping for more with this, in a way, but then again, it works. Yeah. I seem to remember the hired worker at one point, when he got to the end there, veering to the right a little bit. But I don't know if that was a mod. But, ah well, he does the job. So until they actually start veering to the right a little bit to give them that extra turn, it's always going to leave that patch, which is a shame. But at 1.2 is running around at 12 mile an hour, he's doing alright. He's not doing bad at all. But I figured I'd show it, just in case we could spot any differences. I'll let him get a bit carried away here. He's let him turn around, should have stopped him there and then driven, because I wanted to see what it does at speed. This is what's really interesting about patch 1.3, the speed of vehicles, how the stick and the sliding affects. But here we go, get a bit of a run up and then stick it on full lock. Whee! Crunch! Yeah. Right, let's see what the new one does. No obviousness there. So using foot pedals in that as well, I'm not always on it like you would with the keyboard. Should have maybe done the testing with the keyboard. I'm too used to trying to drive it properly, so I vary things too much rather than just gunning it. It becomes apparent with the bales later on. We'll get there, we're nice and smooth to the end again, maxed out, 12 mile an hour. Case is good. But we knew that anyway, we've been playing it long enough. It didn't do what I was hoping for there, which was a little right turn first, but we can live with it, we're used to it by now. This is the cool part coming up. I got a bit brave and I did overdo it. Doesn't quite show what 1.3 is capable of. But you've got to make your own mind up, I suppose. Everybody has their own opinion, what they can get away with, what they can't get away with. But yeah, we've gone it down here, we spin it, and it doesn't quite crunch until there. But it doesn't lock up as bad. I mean, that was really, really fast to take a corner like that with a cedar. Give or take. Next thing, let's do some trailer work. We will run down with the brand. Ah, this is an interesting thing I've spotted as well. I like this a lot. I do like this a lot. Patch 1-2 will run away. As you can see, trailer skips out a bit. Ugh. You get nervous. Drifting, sliding, lots of correcting. Trailer skipping about. Oh, horrendous. I've got used to driving steady now, so it doesn't really affect me that much. There, that was bad. That was really bad. You see it with the truck later on, just how bad that sliding is. But people are complaining about this as well, how much things slow down when they're going up a hill. Have you seen how steep this incline is? There is a good few tons in that trailer. This is a hell of a hill. It's gonna slow down. I don't care what it is. It's not gonna have an easy time going up this hill. Not with a full trailer, even the Brantner. There is a lot of weight there. And it's not dragging it along a flat surface. It's trying to take it up a hill. I mean, it's not quite a deadlift, but Jesus, it is a good bit. Whee! Crunch. Now, I haven't got the fixed rot. I don't think I've got any mods in the mod folder, actually. It is complete base game. Like 1.3, here we go. But yeah, because of the way it locks, you don't get to see how far it can push it, or how far it does push it quite as much. Turning angle's really bad. So glad we came up with that one. Flooring it down here. I think it's the truck shows off that 1.2 runs away. There, look at that. Stuck to it. Stuck again. And you notice the trailer's not snapping around. It's following smoothly. It's not just the tractors have tweaked. As proven from the cedar, if you go silly, it will still slip. But look at that. Kept it on this side. It has to put over steering now. Too used to 1.2. And it seems to get better up the start of the hill. And then the actual incline takes effect. Again, it's a hell of a hill. But we definitely have more grip. Definitely. That's good. Less sliding. I want a cup of tea. Get to the end, open her up, and try and jackknife it again. And this time, she just turns. How cool is that? Right then. Bigger trailers. Get some weight on the back here. Now this is 1.2 again, guys. You know pretty much what's going to happen here. You've opened her up on this hill before. You know how it goes at the end. I think I actually break a little bit. I pussy it out too many times. I've come down here and lost it. Yeah, there you go. Look at that. Nice to hang on to it. Just to do in there. Oh dear. Trailer skipping again. It's that snap that gives it away. Douche. There's your drift. Good old 1.2. But this is what we've been used to. So I've been driving to accommodate that drift. Really, I'm having to push myself here to actually force myself to put the boot down. But we figured it out. Did a little bit of lost it there as well. It's close. Oh, so now we've got a big slog up the hill. Just imagine how much weight is in that trailer. It's full. I mean, it's a heavy trailer on its own, but then with all the crop in it as well, that is a hell of a weight. A hell of a weight. I couldn't even begin to estimate the tonnage. I'd have to look into it. I've not, what is it, 33? It says there, but it's still small on the screen I'm reading. I think it's 33,000. Or thereabouts. My screen's too small to read. 32,000. I'm watching this back in Movie Maker and doing the voiceover. It's that tiny little preview window. Yeah, that's there's a lot of weight there. That is a big incline. Without making the game stupid, you're not going to get anything up there at speed. Simple as. And we don't really get enough speed up at the end here to do a decent sharp turn, I don't think. It'll make it to about 20 mile an hour. And whack. Crunch. But you can barely tell because the turn on that Flieger is so bad. 1.3, here we go. Down the hill. Open her up. Give her some pasty. I think I let off. Maybe this one? No. Might be another one. I'm sure it's the low loader when I really demonstrate that. But we'll get to that point. And then obviously it turn. Oh look, it's stuck to the road. Oh look, it's stuck again. But is that too much? 30 mile an hour in a tractor doing a right angle turn? I don't know. Maybe they've gone too far now. There you go, oversteered again. Trying to counter something that just isn't there. And the big slog up the hill. Da, 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 da. You're not getting up these hills quick. Not with any kind of realism. Remember, it is farming simulator. It's not perfect, but it's the best we've got. And it'll keep getting better. We'll get to the top and we will test the jackknife attack. I'm sure it makes the turn, but again, with that lock being so poor, it's hard to tell. I should have put the mod on, shouldn't I? Just we could have seen if it jackknifed or not. I think this makes the turn. But you've just seen down the bottom of the hill how much better it stuck to the road. Brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. Loved it. And here we go. Whack. Yeah, not sure. Oh, did she lift? I can't tell. Oh well. Right then. And now, the donuts. As you can see, 1.2. Whee! It appears that this truck has more torque than anything else. She drifts left, right and centre. I don't quite get these drifts right. That one screwed up. This one screwed up. And that would have been a beautiful drift. We could have just carried that on round. Oh well. Then the front starts sliding as well, and it's just not happening. When the front goes, you've lost everything. There's no sort of way of overpowering the front again. Really, if you carry it well, there's, I don't know, default, no drive control, so the front is driven. With drive control, I think it's only the back two that drive until you put four-wheel drive on. But then again, I haven't tested drive control with 1.3 yet, because drive control is supposed to have a fix for some of this sliding, which means it overwrites the default game. Now, if it overwrites the default game, it will overwrite 1.3. Here's 1.3. No donuts. It actually drives. Good or bad, depending on what you were, just how much you enjoyed the drifting. I enjoyed a little bit. We don't seem to be able to get any with the truck now. Or the pickup. If there is some, it's very, very slight. But you can still jump it. Just. But yeah, she just seems to stick now. I don't know, that's kind of take a bit of the fun out. I used to enjoy drifting that. Maybe it sticks a little too well. But I have already made a mod of this, so I can play about with that to my heart's content. But again, if I'm not exactly sure how many points it's had, but if you put your foot right to the floor, it was going to light up. The rear wheels were going to spin up, and she was going to drift. Simple. If you're using the keyboard, you're kind of screwed. If you've got steering wheel and pedals, happy days. Possibly. Alright then. Now, I actually never noticed this, because until recently I'd not done anything with potatoes. Not that I remember anyway. But the particle system's apparently screwed up on this thing. Now, I'm not sure if it's only multiplayer, but watching it here, the top, very top belt doesn't get a particle. See, it comes up, then stops. Then it starts. Strange but true. What kind of bugs me about these machines as well, the trailer starts filling up before the particle system gets to the end. But 1.3. Just got away from the turnaround, I was a bit quick. But while we wait, I have a cup of tea. Aha. And as you can see this time, still starts filling straight away, but the particle system is instant, which is cool. So they have done some work in there. Good times. Good times. Got an itch. And the next part, the plough. Now, the case, and you can see a little bit of a drift there, should be able to handle this plough. Not go sideways. Well, this is 1.2. This is where we expect to see issues. I didn't do too bad on that one. But wait till we get to the end of this next pass. Aye. It's an interesting way how Giant's actually implemented the underpowered effect. But again, it shouldn't do it. That would have weight on the front as well. But it really shows itself up here. Look at that go. Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear. Yeah. 1.2. Not good for ploughing. However, straight as a die. Look at that. So ploughing 1.3, much improved. Again, we do two passes just to show it when we get to the danger area when it was climbing uphill. That seems to have really struggled. But again, straight all the way. So the case now is able to pull stuff. That'll be interesting with some of the mods out there. See how they match up and compare. I'm excited. I'm excited for this patch. Again, this is only the first stage of the patch. It's out for testing so we can give feedback. But yeah, look at that. Straight. All the way. Love it. Love it. Right then guys, now let's test out the loader. This is patch 1.2. Watch the truck. This isn't pretty. The trailer skipping out. The truck itself, no steering. Front wheels just broke traction and that was it. Understeer, that one's called. But I'm still going. Speaking with the commentary. I think I was trying to get the trailer to kick out again, but we didn't have enough speed. Well, let's load her up and I'll show you what she does then. I am definitely having issues with the mod. After testing this, I am definitely having issues with the mod. There is a mod I am using that is screwing up how this trailer works. I have no idea what though. But it's a problem. Every time I use this trailer in game, it's always thrown off the vehicle, it's lost it. It's just slowly but surely drifted off and fallen. Which is really annoying, because it means I'm going to have to go through everything. But easy enough to load. The only problem I have here is the truck drifting around and the trailer. I can say that because I've done it now. It's the only way to get those off was to do something really stupid, like the full 90 degree angle and then turn, which kind of defeated the object. If that's how you want to play the game, well, you're going to have to do some modding. But I did try heavy braking and they never moved. So yeah, kind of got me stuck on this one. It would be interesting to know which mod is breaking this trailer. It's a dynamic, giant zone dynamic attacher that's on it, that's all that's holding them still. And it appears to work very, very well. A lot better than what I've been experiencing anyway. Now we'll take her up the ride. Notice again a bit of understeer. She does get up this hill pretty well though. Gosh, is it 400 brake the wagon on this tractor unit? I don't know. Off the top of my head, I'd have to go back in game and check. Yeah, gets up there quite well, the two dykes on the back. And there is a little bit of rough ground here. We nearly lose one of them. Ooh, how close is that? But even then, it lands and it locks again. The thing with the dynamic attacher is, when it holds it fast until you hit a certain force. When you brake too sharp, you hit a wall, or you go over a bump too fast, then it breaks it. There is a setting in the XML of each vehicle that uses it on at what point it should brake and release whatever it's holding. But the theory behind it is really, really good. I thought the implementation was crap, but like I say, it's a mod that's doing it. Because even after all that, they're still on the trailer. Annoying. Very annoying. Anyway, 1.3. What's the truck? Again, it's the drivability. So much better. But again, have they gone a bit too far now? 40 mile an hour there. Takes the corner. The back end did kick out a bit there though. I think it was back in 13 with MR, they used to actually tip rather than slide. Getting something to actually tip on 15 is no mean feat. I believe that's the right phrase. But yeah, tipping someone over in 15 seems to be quite difficult. Managed it a couple of times, but not much. Testing a truck earlier on today actually, I managed to get that to tip. But then again, it was a mod. And after checking the log, it's not a mod I'm going to be using. Far too much wrong with it. But here we go. Acceleration seems to be a little more realistic. I'm not entirely sure what they've changed to get the things to stick better. I don't know if it's a main script they've altered or if it's each individual XML and they've left the game alone. I just don't know. one way to find out if it's play with some mods, I suppose. The pickup mod will be a good one. If I can still do donuts in it, that'll answer the question. Again, hard braking, didn't move. But it didn't move on 1.2 either. Yeah, the truck sticks a lot better. I mean, even the tree bashing them there. Totally forgot about that. So I've had this save game for a while, actually. I did a lot of early testing on it. Oh yeah, they stick on really well. So the truck sticks a lot better. But again, maybe too much now. I remember this is where we need the tipping part now. It's got the traction, and now it should tip if it goes over. I wonder if that could be tweaked by the centre of mass. Something to think about possibly in the future. But for drivability, you can be a little bit more careless now. Again, I think I'm sure I go over that rough bit again here. I'll try to at least. But nothing great. Oh, I've just missed it, look. Gone a bit too far. Yeah, just missed it. But nothing moved anyway. I believe this though, I'll let off the acceleration here. There you go. And it slows it down. 1.2 didn't. Yeah, you can hear it's not accelerating now. 1.2 just coasted. So the engine braking has been reinforced again. That was a hell of a hill. Yeah, cut him up, but he stops. The truck sticks, so there's no worry about hitting the trees. But I'm happy. Course play will enjoy it a lot more. You don't have to be quite so strict with course play now. Now the fun part. Now I didn't really expect any change with the round baler as such, and we don't really find one. Obviously I've started off here driving around with it running, just to see if it majorly affects it. But it didn't seem to care. I think the tractor's a bit overpowered really to show off anything with a round baler. But it works. Round baling, quite happy. Wait till we get to the bale stacking. You will appreciate that. I know I did. But as you can see, no real difference. Maybe it actually pulls it a little better. Going up hills and stuff. I'm not sure now. Maybe as I'm watching it back, I think it's actually moving faster in 1.3. Oh, that's nice to know. Right, but then we get to the stacking. I think these are the longest segments of the video. We're staying on 1.2 for this part because it's round bale, round bale. No, we're not, just round bales. The previous bit was the baling. Duh. But yeah, 1.2. And this brings up more curiosities. As you can see, the first bale, perfectly placed. I think this bale causes me problems on both sections, actually. There, little git. Some bales just don't play nice. Again, because it's a three-time bale fork, it's meant for, well, ideally it's designed for the big squares, so you can only get two into this. Now because we're loading the trailer from this side, we're keeping the spare fork on the right so we can push the bales up together. If you're loading it from the other side, you'd have the bale over to the right hand side of the forks and leave the spare fork, or spare tine? Spike? I'm not sure what they're called. Everything's got its own little word, hasn't it? Its own name. I'm going to go Spike. Yeah, I'm going with Spike. Yeah, by the end of this, when the trailer is fully loaded, it does not look pretty. The bales come to life. I think, yeah, it's already started to dance. Look at number one now. What the hell? Number two's just jumped up as well. What's going on there? This is 1.2, by the way. So even try and put them back down, they just resist. Yeah. Number one's gone even further, and now number three's jumping, look. Well, I know from my own episodes that I've had trouble with the round bales, but I thought it was one of the mods. Possibly not, after watching this. Like I said, there are no mods in here. Actually, there may be the mod for the front loader. I think I put that in, the one me and Satis are working on. I need to test that on the forestry stuff as well, to find out what the error is, so we can correct it. But I do go in for a full trailer here, that's why it's taking a long time. Two escapees. Now, this is the longest part of the video and possibly the boring part, but it's interesting to see how these bales behave. Look at the first three now. There's no wonder I had to build a cage on the Marshall, is there, when they were doing that? What an absolute pain in the ass. They're in a flip 90 degrees, the bloody things. Yeah, there was no way I was picking that up from that angle. But we tried. Yeah, nudging it didn't go so well previously, so I'll give it up. But here we go, I think this is the last bale. I wonder if we have another one kicking around. There was no point filling up the trailer because, but I didn't have enough bales for a start, and that was daft. I underestimated the size of the thing. There we go, one of them's flipped. Number four's on its way. One and two are going further. And there's a survivor. One left. I do like this JCB 320. I think it's a 320. Small viewport, can't see. I do like the machine. Do they have a steering? I think I got a steering wheel towards the end of 13. The little Widerman would have been a wonderful machine with that. The bendies are horrible when you only use by keyboard. They're near enough impossible to drive. For any delicate work like loading bales. Right, keep your eyes on, guys. I think has number three actually flipped over and then gone a further again? Where is it? Okay, number three just sat down. I'm not surprised because it's at a stupid angle. It's like they're fighting with each other constantly. They're just not happy. I'm pretty sure they've all moved a little bit to the left as well. So this is definitely a bale related issue. Now the last two are dancing there. Two, three and four are all sat down near enough. The last one makes a break for freedom there. That was when I was going for the excessive break to see if anything moved, and that one jumped. Anyway, 1.3. Here we go. Well, this is actually a very pleasant experience. And this is probably the biggest change I can demonstrate aside from the donuts. So there's loads of other little tweaks and bits and pieces, but these are the biggest ones for me. The biggest ones I've noticed, anyway. The bale stack is a lot less painful with the big square bale. I think it's 3 to fill the trailer. I'll get a full row. Right then, last time number one had already started to dance. Hasn't moved. How cool is that? I can maybe use the normal Marshall trailer instead of having to make the stupid cage thing that I did. But that'll probably help out the potato boxes at the minute. But there is a possibility that 1.3 fixes them as well. There you go. Number 3's on. 1 and 2 haven't moved. It's looking good. Keep the bales coming. There we go. 4 on. The previous ones not moving at all. I also noticed this telehandler behaving funny. On the MP Let's Play, when we stood near it, it started sliding. Now that seems to behave in itself as well. I don't know if I recorded that though. Yeah, so much for nudge. And driving without the drive control shuttle control is a real challenge. The off camera bits to these videos, I started getting very frustrated. So I've got the button to reverse it on my mouse. You normally just flick the button, then you can use accelerator to brake, cushion it and go in reverse. No shuttle? Nah, not happening. But 5 on, 4 haven't moved. How cool is that? Could it be we have bailing without the tears, the stress, the anger, the hate? These signs seem promising. Like I said before though, there is a possibility that mods have been designed to correct the flaws within the game, within 1.2 itself, so that would mean they overwrite giant scripts. Now when you have those still in your mod folder, they will continue to overwrite giant scripts, so the fixes from 1.3 won't take effect. It's a possible, I don't know for certain, I have yet to put 1.3 on either of the Let's Players with a full mod folder. Psyching myself up for it. But hopefully there'll be no major issues, at least with the main mods, such as drive control and that. If it works with Cosplay, that'll be so nice. Checking on the forums, there's not been too many concerns just yet. There's a few lazy people asking if it does this, that and the other, when you can easily jump into a game and test it for yourself. Seems to be all the forums are at the minute is just complaining. I don't understand. I'm enjoying the game. I'm really enjoying the game. I mean, a couple of these sixes are nice, but I've been enjoying it since it came out on 1.1. And I was enjoying 1.2, and I'm going to continue to enjoy 1.3. Right, you see, the only issue there was the last one. That was the only one that rolled. I was loading the trailer on a slope, so... I need a way of fixing that is to put, rather than a perfectly round collision on them, some kind of hexagon, pentagon. Give them flat edges, they ain't really nowhere then. But the collisions will be off. But, as you can see, nothing. They are where they were placed. This is good. This is very good. I'm excited about this. These are round bales, doing as they're told. And, hard braking, only one of them twitched. As you can see, the tractor's not sliding. The trailer's not sliding. And, more importantly, the bales are not sliding. How cool is that? Epic. But now, a big question that we've had is why can't the case and the Sammy and such like pull a baler that's only rated at 120 brake? I said this map's fairly forgiving, but still. Fire her up, she's at 15. That's the maximum it'll speed bail at. When you go up this hill, drops right off. But then when you're going up and down as well, nothing. Absolutely nothing. It's slowly climbing, isn't it? But there, you're 5 mile an hour off what you should be. Oh, there we go, back into the single digits. I think it was Calfar, the OEB, well, another OEB lad doing Let's Plays. He had this, I think it was this exact setup on Cobra, and he just got stuck. He could not make it run. I think I had, what did I use now? I think it was back on my first Let's Play on Beyond Home, where I came across the issue. I think I ended up using either the Lamborghini or the Deutz. Yeah, coming back down, 15 mile an hour. Back up the little hill. Just annihilates the speed again. Right, if you weren't, didn't have the baler running, it'd be fine. Anyway, 1.3. Check this out. Obviously the nice straight flat road, which is at 15, full speed. Around we go up the little bumps. Now anything above 8 mile an hour is good. Oh look at that, it only dropped to 10. And it's climbing. What is this craziness? Epic. Well done, Giants. That right there is beautiful. You do also have to take into account the size of the baler, but I think it's using 120, this is a 203 brake tractor, you've still got 80 ponies spare to drag the weight around. That should be plenty. And these aren't killer hills either, this is just a little bump and then a gentle slope. This tractor should have no problem moving around at these speeds. There you go, maxed out, up the hill. Awesome. And now we move on to the square bales. I'll be honest, I didn't notice an issue here. But that was when I was doing it and having to pay attention to driving. Now we're watching it back, let's see what we come across. I'm pretty sure this goes smoothly. But if it's not broke, don't fix it, because then you end up breaking it. Especially with scripting. I've discovered that on my feeble attempts. Oh, it could take far, couldn't it? Looking at that? Possibly, it'd be close. Ah yeah, I've got to nudge that first one up as well. There we go. Yeah, she looks like she'll take 4 per row then. I actually feel like I'm driving, even though I'm just sat here watching it back. Okay, then go for 3, then put 1 on top and take it for the test. That's it, I'm pretty sure I don't notice a change. But again, you're not going to fly around at maximum speed with a bale trailer on the back. You wouldn't do it in real life. You'd tip the damn thing. There's limits. Again, when you're using the keyboard, I can understand it's harder to try and balance the speed. You have to play about with the cruise control a lot more. Now, the bonus of a steering wheel is you have a lot more control. You can actually drive these, the bendies. Can't drive a bendy on keyboard, not without the auto steer mod. I don't know if it's been released for 15. I know Matt, who has done his mouse control. Well, mouse steering, and that's fantastic. He's updated it as well now. You actually use the scroll wheel to speed up and slow down, which is cool, and then use the mouse to steer, but it holds it. So it's possible to drive with that. Right, then here we go, guys. Watch the bales. I'm pretty sure the stick. So it's only the round bales that were douchebags. Well, again, you'd slow down for a corner like that, you wouldn't take it at full speed. I couldn't bring myself to do it, even to test. A nice slow corner, we're up at 25 mile an hour. They haven't moved. This is 1.2. Again, it leads me to believe one of my mods is playing the hard braking. Fine. Actually, check 1.2, see if it's sliding. I can't see anything. I can't remember the last time I used square bales though. Must have been on Bjornholm. Could have been before the mod that's causing the problem came out. Because obviously that's not sliding. At 1.3. And I believe this is the last segment, guys. We had no issues with the square bales there in 1.2. So if we have anything in 1.3, that would suck. But all seems to be well. But the difference in the round bales, and to actually catch it on camera like that, that's amazing. That is a hell of an improvement. I didn't notice anything up with the square bales, but there could have been something underlying. Same issue with the round bales, possibly. But because the square bales, they behave a little bit better due to the collision. But if they put whatever they've done to the round bales onto the square bales, in theory the square bales are going to be fantastic as well now. Actually being able to bale. I'm getting a real kick out of baling at the minute as well. It's no longer, doesn't sort of feel like self-harm anymore. Is it with the dog? Killed up on my feet, wonder if he's alright. Right, here we go then, guys. The test. As expected, stick like glue. Obviously, the vehicle's handled a lot of it. Nothing's going to slide at 30 mile an hour, is it? But again, it's a right angle turn. If you take that corner and you hit a rut, things are going to bounce. If you're going fast, 20 mile an hour, it's going over. It's surprising how much a rut or a bump in the ground can really fuck you over. Like driving the loading shovel at work, when we're going over rough ground, you're pushing up, something falls back underneath you and ends up under your wheel as you're lifting. You've got your bucket in the air, your centre of gravity is all to cock. There we go, our braking, fine. Yeah, but that bump, if you're driving slow, you'll feel your machine going. But if you hit it harder, the tyre's the only suspension you have on a loading shovel, it bounces it. You go a lot further. Also, with a full bale trailer, that bounce can be, yeah, the difference between going over and staying still. Anyway, one more interesting little thing. In the menus, check this out. We have a new page. Now, I haven't tested it on Aldridge yet, but that could be epic for all the different storages. Anyway, my final opinion. Yes, please. I want this. I want this a lot. Thanks, guys.